Welcome to Beekeeping UK, and today we're going to be having a look at Zircan's Apipasta Fondant. Okay, so let's jump straight into this review. So basically, we're going to be looking at three different types of the fondants that Zircan actually produce. We've only got the three. I think there's maybe four different types, one being the syrup. Now have a quick look at some of the stuff we've got on the table today and its benefits. So, let's slide these two aside. These are two recent ones that we bought, and this, which I'm getting all over the table, is one that we usually use. So this is Apipasta from Zircan. It's a 1 kilogram packet. They're quite thick packets, not like the stuff that you get from Oldcastle Farm, but still they're quite compact. They're not big and bulky and annoying to carry around. 1 kilogram packets. So these two, this is a standard Apipasta, just a fondant, nothing added. Here, this is this, but with vitamins. So that's a nice little touch there. Both of them are 1 kilogram packets, and these come in boxes of 15, just these two. And then this one here, which is the whole thing, the whole shebang, is the Apipasta Plus. This comes in a box of 14 just because of the size of it. So this one here, we've used it, works really well. It's a shame it's not like the other one and quite low down, but for the price, you know, the way it is, presentation is really easy to use, which I'll show you in a bit. Let's get straight into just this one here. This is Apipasta with added vitamins. Really, really good. Easier for the bees to digest. Also, according to the website, builds up an immunity to pesticides. Never heard that before, but haven't done a great deal of research into adding vitamins into fondants. But it seems to be pretty popular. We thought we'd have a try. Bought a couple of boxes up in Bee Trade, which is, yeah, it's really good. Like I said, boxes are 15 of these. Little ones, you can find all the information. The main distributors here in the UK are Modern Beekeeping, also known as Happy Valley. I'll leave the link down below in the description so you can check them out yourself. We have these little cutouts here. It tells you where to cut them. So it's actually quite useful. As simple as it sounds, it's a really useful little thing. So this is actually the size of a hole which you find in your crown board. And this one is just kind of like a bigger one. I tend to just cut out a bigger one and smack it on just because I haven't got a lot of time. But if you want to, you can cut it out like that, nice and easy. Just gives you a bit of a guideline. So if you're messy like me, you don't make a mess all over the top of the crown board, which I usually do. So this is, as simple as it sounds, it does help. You know, so it says here, if it's a weak beehive, you know, if it's small, then just cut out this little one. If it's strong, you can cut out this bigger version so that more of them can get in. 1 kilogram slab, if they're that big, cut out the big version, whack two of them on, especially if they haven't got a great deal of feed. Yeah, so this is the added vitamins one. It's really well priced, actually. If you go down into the description, you can have a look at them. If you want to buy a pallet of it, message the guys there, good as gold, and they'll sort you out a really, really competitive price. So the next one that we're going to have a look at is This is the whole thing. This is the top of the range. This is the Ferrari of the group. So yeah, this is Apipasta Plus. This again is 1 kilogram. It feels a bit bigger. Nice hard duty plastic. Clumsy like me, drop it on the floor, you know, throw it around a bit. It's not gonna break, is it? I believe it's a similar type of packaging for their a syrupy type of version. You can get it in drums as well, I think. But their syrupy version, you can get in a packet like this, so it's pretty hard duty. That's what you want, especially if you're lugging them around all day. How to use, it just says, according to the state of the hive, cut along the dotted line, remove the film, place down on the frames. So yeah, place down the frames, put it on the whole of the crown board, it's up to you, so whatever you do. You know, you can either whack an econ straight onto the frames. Again, you know, you've got your two outlines, your weak beehives and your strong beehives. It's kind of a bigger area. So, you know, we're coming into, where are we now? We're coming up to April. In the next couple of months, it's all going to be kicking off. I'm going to have nukes that I want to be building up. I want them to be laying. I want them to have a head start. At this current time of the year, we're starting to get pollen in. I think it was a couple of days ago, maybe a couple of weeks ago, by the time I've uploaded this video, we've had, you know, our first bulky load of pollen coming into the hives. It's not a massive variety, but there's a little bit of pollen into the hive. This is what you want. Gives them a bit of a variety for once. And also, it'll kick start them off for the year. So that's, you know, a great little push for them. If you want them to be building up now, you want the pollen to be coming into the hive, you want the queen to be breeding, you want the bees to be big. So this is really good for nukes. If you're building up nukes, these are really good. So if you're building up nukes, this is along the lines of what you want. You want to have something that's really, really going to kickstart them off, get them breeding, get the queen breeding, get the bees up and running for the season. Putting these on the nukes, either that or also your vitamins, added vitamins, that's also going to help, either really. The standard is good, it's worked, we've used it throughout a couple of seasons. And I think it's more for like a midwinter kind of thing, you just smack it on. But this time of year is really crucial. You want your bees to be as big as possible, because if you're going into the season with a little hive, trying to keep it up and running, and you could be wasting your time, you're trying to get honey off it, you've only got a couple of frames of bees. It's the most annoying thing, and I've had hives, you're trying to keep alive, you're trying to keep them going, they're not producing much honey, you're spending a lot of time with them, and maybe something like this could have got them that little bit bigger, could have got me that extra super, you never know. So we're going to be testing these out in the next couple of weeks now. We've got quite a few boxes which we purchased down at the Bee Trade X. We're going to go get them on the hives and then we'll let you know. So what I want you to do is do me a big favour, like the video if you enjoyed, please subscribe, and also press the bell once you've subscribed so that you get a notification, and that will then tell you if I upload any videos about any of my past subjects. Day in the Life of the Bee Farmer will be coming on soon, once the summer kicks off. Season 2 will be up and running, and also you'll be able to see how these turn out and whether they are as good as I have been told. So thank you very much for watching. Remember, leave a like, and I'll see you guys soon.